Welcome back to this video on the solution of nonlinear equations using open methods. In the previous video, we talked about the Newton-Raphson method and how we derive the relation. In this video, we will present a simple algorithm. Actually, the Newton-Raphson method is quite simple, so the algorithm will not be that complex. The algorithm of Newton-Raphson method, like other algorithms in searching for the roots of problems, will start by an initial guess. Here we distinguish the bracketing methods from the open methods by that here we only need, in Newton-Raphson, we need only a single initial guess. Probably when we come to the secant method, the method that we're going to present later, the secant method also starts with two guesses, but it has a different way of solving the problem. Anyway, now for Newton-Raphson, we start with the initial guess. Following that, we evaluate the function and the slope. So we have two pieces of information that we need to get, the function and the slope of the function at the guess we have. Following that, we determine the tolerance and the maximum number of iterations. The tolerance is the accepted error, and the maximum number of iterations, how many times to use the algorithm. This is just to prevent the algorithm from going infinitely in case we could not find a solution. Finally, we initiate the counter that counts the number of iterations. Now to the kernel, or to the heart of the algorithm, start by incrementing the counter, add one to it, then evaluate the current approximation, xk plus 1, which is going to be equal to xk minus f over f prime. This is the relation that we got from Newton-Raphson method, so we are going to use it here. Then we check if we are extremely lucky, which usually doesn't happen, that f of xk plus 1 is equal to 0, then we are done. We don't need to go any further. We already found the solution, but this doesn't usually happen. Then comes the other check, whether the relative error is less than the tolerance or not. If it is less than the tolerance, then we are good enough. Our solution has converged and we are there. Or almost there, but acceptably. Otherwise, we continue and check for the maximum number of iterations. If we have reached maximum number of iterations, then we end, and we couldn't find a solution in that case. Otherwise, we also continue. Then we put the new value in the old one, because now we are ready to go back and iterate again. So each time we do this search, we check whether we approached or not. If not, then we replace the old value with the new one and go back and run the algorithm again. As you can see here, it's quite a simple algorithm compared to other ones. I mean, we haven't presented actually any complex algorithm yet. This one is quite simple also, and the program, as we're going to see later, is quite simple as well and finds the solution relatively quickly. In the next video, we will use the Newton-Raphson method to find the solution for a problem through an example. It's a small example, one-dimensional problem. Then we are going to take that example and try to solve it on the computer. As a matter of fact, this is the core of this course. You need to learn how to use a computer program to find the solution of different numerical problems, because that's why we use numerical techniques, to get the computer doing things. So I hope to see you next video.